I've been itching to get my hands on the new Framework 12 since it was first revealed back in February, and it's finally here on the iFixit Teardown table. This 12.2-inch touchscreen laptop converts to a tablet thanks to the new 360-degree hinge and offers maximum compatibility across a variety of stylus devices by supporting both MPP 2.0 and USI 2.0. There's an official Framework stylus too, but the stylus isn't currently available to purchase, so we'll have to come back to it later when we get our hands on one. One of the first things that stands out about the Framework 12 is the feel of the exterior shell. It's not the smooth, polished feel of aluminium or the light plastic I'm used to seeing, and that's because the plastic and metal central frame is over-molded with shock-absorbing TPU, or thermoplastic polyurethane. This thing is a workhorse. It's made for school and college. It's made for drops and spills. It's made to take a beating, and if it breaks, it's made to be repairable. So let's take a look inside the Framework 12 and see if it's the laptop and tablet that is going to get your kids through school, college, and beyond. By the way, one of my favorite things about other Framework laptops is the ability to easily replace a broken screen. The Framework 12 makes that process even easier. Just power the device off and access the panel from underneath the plastic bezel. We'll look at that full process at the end of the teardown. I'll go ahead and remove the expansion cards before opening up the case. These are the same expansion cards we've seen in all the Framework laptops, but there's a new locking tab design here that keeps the cards in place, mimicking the Framework 16 rather than the push button on the Framework 13. Then it's just a matter of loosening all the T5 screws on the bottom of the case. These are all captive, as are the majority of the screws inside the Framework 12. Just like the other Framework devices, the Framework 12 opens up from the keyboard side, and this iteration has a very cool implementation of the keyboard connector, pogo pins. There's no cable to disconnect, instead the pogo pins make contact with the copper pads on the underside of the keyboard. The trackpad comes away just as easily with a few more T5 screws. And if you do lose one of those non-captive screws, not to worry. The repair-minded engineers at Framework included a set of spares. It's a very clever and thoughtful use of the extra space inside the chassis. Now, you might expect this orange pull tab to be the battery connector, but that's not the case. Just like the keyboard, the ribbon cable is gone in favor of prongs that slide away once the screws are removed. Battery replacement doesn't get much easier than that. Moving on to the upgradable modules, the DDR5 5600 RAM sticks are the first to come away. Just like the RAM, the short M.2-2230 SSD has a clever tool-free securing mechanism too. This SSD is the same form factor used in the Steam Deck, by the way, which you can find in the iFixit store. Another captive T5 screw and a couple of coax cables gives me the wireless card. From there, we can proceed to remove the power button board and the audio board. As I'm removing the speakers, it's worth mentioning again that each component has a QR code that leads to the relevant repair guides. It's time to take a closer look at the thermals on the mainboard, starting with the fan. A single JSD-style connector and a couple of captive screws hold the fan as a single module. Removing the display connectors and the five very clearly marked mainboard screws releases the hardware at the heart of the Framework 12. Any major future upgrade will involve replacing this mainboard, which, as you've seen, is a very easy task. We didn't really need to remove the fan or heatsink to get this mainboard out. In fact, any upgrade kit will include the thermal management elements along with the mainboard. But it is nice to see how easy it is to remove the fan and clean it, and to remove the heatsink to reapply thermal paste if needed. Coming back to that screen, once again I'm going to remove the plastic bezel that is held in place by both magnets and clips to expose the screws holding the panel in place along the bottom edge of the screen. There's a small circular opening in the middle of the screen big enough for a T5 bit or spudger tip to fit into. Sliding that down releases the screen from the screen housing. Then it's just a matter of disconnecting a couple of flex cables, the camera assembly, and its connecting cable, which allows me to remove the panel. That's one of the easiest glue-free panel replacements I've ever seen, the next easiest being in the Framework 13. So how does the Framework 12 stack up against other laptops, including the Framework 13 and Framework 16? Well, there's an awful lot to love about this laptop when it comes to repairability. From its durable design to the color-coded and extensively annotated internals that point you to the relevant repair guides, the Framework 12 checks all the boxes in our wishlist for repairability. The easily removable battery with reusable fasteners is an easy win that we'd expect to see in all Framework devices, but the tool-free SSD removal procedure and backup screws found on the inside show a commitment to the user upgrade and repair experience that simply doesn't exist in anything else we've seen before. There's room for improvement, there always is, but as a best-in-class device from a repairability perspective, we're proud to say that the Framework 12 earns a score of 10 out of 10 on our laptop repairability scorecard. With parts, guides, and a commitment to provide upgrades into the foreseeable future, the Framework 12 is likely going to be around for a good long while.